And up and up. Your water bill just keeps on climbing, and it's now higher than ever. Tonight, an exclusive Five on Your Side investigation digs into exactly where your money's going.
Five on Your Side Chief Investigator Ron Regan joins us. And Ron, despite spending millions, Cleveland Water has repeatedly violated drinking water regulations.
And while you're paying more than ever for water, Cleveland Water is allowing critical equipment to fail. Here's what happened when we tried to get answers.
We're focused on the boil advisory today.
That's Public Utilities Director Robert Davis. He oversees the safety of the water you drink. And recently touted success before a council committee that oversees his department.
To do better and be better.
But we found that did not happen at two of Cleveland's largest treatment plants, providing drinking water to thousands. Both violated safe drinking water standards. Violations neither Davis nor his water commissioner reported in this presentation.
The most important metric is that we get zero treatment technique violations, and it's been at least 4 or 5 years, I want to say, before we've even had one of those.
Instead, a PowerPoint claimed only this.
Again, 2018, a long-running record of no violations for treatment techniques.
Instead, we found eight other types of EPA violations since 2014, ranging from equipment failures to lab records. At Nottingham, critical equipment failed, allowing sediment to build up. That can affect the clarity of the water you drink. And at Baldwin, a power outage lasted 11 full hours, discharging chlorinated water into a nearby creek. We found not a single electrician was on duty. In a letter to the EPA, the plant manager admitted he tried calling an electrician, but couldn't reach him. As a result, the EPA requested an action plan for responding to future power outages.
This is one of the largest utilities in the nation. Yeah. Why wouldn't you have a full-time electrician on duty? Is there a reason for that?
If you're the drinking water public, you scratch your head and say, well, wait a minute. You don't have an electrician on call?
Heidi Robertson teaches environmental law. She reviewed multiple EPA violations over the last 2 years.
Our water isn't undrinkable. It's not unsafe. But the other thing I see is it shows us that we have a seriously aging infrastructure, perhaps a dangerously aging infrastructure.
Infrastructure that costs you 44 cents of every dollar you pay. And despite spending $325 million at both plants, we still found unresolved violations. The EPA is calling a history of noncompliance. At Baldwin, out-of-service filters, and at Nottingham, failures involving critical sludge collection equipment. Failures EPA called a significant deficiency that could cause an unacceptable risk to health and reliable delivery of safe drinking water.
All of those pages and pages of what look to be real problems. To me, that's an indicator of a bigger issue.
But instead of complying, the water department tried to cut staff at both plants. Ohio EPA wouldn't allow it, denying the request. And while Cleveland spends $2 million a year to keep plants secure, not a single electrician on duty during a power outage. Plus, it has plenty of cash for these: water bottles, toothbrushes, and coffee mugs, all part of a $378,000 spending spree to advertise and promote itself.
You have plenty of money for water bottles, toothbrushes, and giveaways. Why wouldn't you have a full-time electrician on duty?
Ron, as we've indicated before, this is a separate issue. We're talking about the boil advisory today.
I've been trying to get an interview with you for at least a month.
We're talking about the safety and health and welfare of our customers at this time.
I've been trying to get an interview.
We will be more than happy to talk to you about that.
You would not be more than happy to talk to me because you turned me down. That's why I'm here.
Thank you.
Why wouldn't one of the largest utilities in the nation have an electrician on duty?
But days before our report was to air, Cleveland's water commissioner agreed to a sit-down interview.
These violations, we acknowledge and we recognize that they've occurred.
And stresses water quality was never affected.
The most important thing that we want to stress is our water is safe. It's eminently safe. It's always been safe.
Well, tomorrow night at 6, how Cleveland Water is responding to our investigation and what it plans to do to keep your water safe. I'm Chief Investigator Ron Regan.
Thank you, Ron. Now, if you have a tip for Ron or the other five on your side investigators, you can send them an email to investigatortips@wews.com.